What's up, amigos? Welcome to the first tutorial of 2023. It's been a while since my last one. A lot of things has happened since. My wife had a baby. We're first-time parents. Woo! We moved a couple times. Hopefully you like that little sketch that I created for you using this Shatter example. Now, we use Trapcode Particular, which is one of the best particle system plugins you can get. It's by Maxon Red Giant. We also use After Effects because you use Particular inside of After Effects. Now let's dive into this tutorial. And before we do, give us a thumbs up, like this video, drop us a comment. And if you're not gonna watch the whole thing, just let it run through. The more you watch it, the better it'll help this channel out. And remember, life is a gift, make it count. To create this shatter effect, you need two shots. One is a performance and another is a clean plate of just simply the background. Now let me show you this raw footage. This is a shot that I shot with my cell phone. The clean plate is at the beginning, followed by the performance of your instructor. Now I highly recommend getting both shots in the same take to eliminate and minimize any small movements in your camera. Now what we'll do is, let's scrub through right here. When the hands go down around 820 is where we want the shatter to start. So let's hit Control K to splice. Let's hit delete and let's go to the beginning, which is the clean plate version, and let's splice it. Let's move it over. Let's connect both shots and there, boom. This is where the shatter will occur. Now what we'll do is the very last frame before we go into the clean plate, we need to export this frame. Make sure that you are in full resolution. Let's go to this camera icon to export the frame. Hit okay. Now let's jump into Photoshop. Let's open that file. And what we want to do is cut it out. So let's go to select, let's go to subject, and Photoshop using AI will try its best to select the subject. One method that I like to do is to go into quick mask. So hit Q to go into quick mask. And what I like to do is hit B for the brush tool. We can go up to, we can use soft brown or hard brown, maybe a size of 25 pixels. Let's zoom in. And using black and white, we can either add or subtract to our selection. So this is a quick way to manually just paint in or paint out the areas that you want to your selection. Once you're done, hit Q again to exit quick mask. And simply go down to this icon to add a layer mask. We'll rename this to CM Cutout. And the last step is to save it as a Photoshop file. Let's jump into After Effects. Let's start by creating a new composition. Let's go ahead and click on the comp icon and simply match the same settings of your video and drop in your cutout frame. Let's make it a 3D layer by activating the 3D switch. Let's go ahead and hide this layer. Now, let's create a solid layer. Go up to layer, new solid. And let's call this particular. And let's make it comp size and hit okay. Now let's add the effect. Let's go up to effect, RG trap code, and let's go to particular. Let's go to emitter and let's play back and let's see what we have. Now, by default, this is what you get when you load particular. What we will be doing is adjusting all these properties or a lot of these properties to drive the shatter effect. Now, the first thing that we need to do is change the emitter behavior to explode. Now, once we switch it to explode, we definitely need to crank up the number of particles per second. Let's make it 20,000. And the second thing, the third thing actually we need to do is change the emitter type from point to a layer. We want to emit from our cutout layer. So let's select layer and down in layer emitter, let's go ahead and select our cutout layer. And once we do, our particles are emitting from our cutout layer. Now a property that you'll probably adjust throughout this process is the velocity. For now we can make it 350. But as you're working and creating this effect, you might have to either dial this up or dial it down. It depends on what type of shatter you want. So this is a parameter that you'll probably adjust throughout this process. Now you can also change the random seed. It'll just change where the particles are being emitted from within your layer. Now let's go down to particle and the particles, the lifespan is set to 3. So at 3 seconds, they disappear. So what we need to do is simply increase this number. Let's make it 15 and let's go back. And what we'll do is for the size, let's increase the size to 35. And the sphere feather, let's make it 0. And you can see that it simply right now by default is emitting circles. What we want to do is change this. And the cool thing about Particular, it has built in several 2D and 3D sprites. So for the particle type, let's go ahead and change it to sprite colorize. And let's choose sprite. And we have 2D shapes that we can choose from. Let's see the 2D shapes. And we also have these 3D geometric shapes, and that's what we'll be using for this shatter effect. We have a whole bunch of other different sprites that you can experiment with. But for this tutorial, let's go ahead and start with, let's use a cube spin so you can see how it looks. Now, it's a little dark, but that's okay. We'll add a color curves. Now, when we go to the sprite, if you choose a gray color sprite, it'll inherit the pixel colors from your cutout. So try to select a gray colored sprite. For example, let's go ahead and go to sphere 4. And what we'll do is a size random. Let's definitely change this because we don't want all the particles to be exactly the same size. We want some to be bigger, some smaller. So let's make this 50%. And the rotation, let's randomize the rotation. Let's make it 45. I mean, these are values that you can, you know, you can make it maybe 60, whatever. It doesn't really matter as long as it's not set to 0. The rest of these properties, pretty much just leave it at its default values. Let's play back and let's see what we have. So we have an explosion of particles. What we need to do is we need to add gravity so they fall down. And we'll do that by going to physics and we'll change the gravity, the value from 0 to 300. And now let's play back. So we have gravity acting upon these particles. They're falling down. The only thing left is to have them bounce. So to do that, let's go up to layer, new solid, change the color. Let's call this floor. Let's make it a 3D layer, activate the 3D switch, hit R for rotation, for the X value for the orientation, make it 270, and let's move it down. And this will be our floor layer. So just position your floor layer where you want the bounce to occur. Now what we can do is we can simply hide this layer, go back to Particular. Let's go to physics. For the model, we'll switch it to bounce, the bounce tab. Let's go to the floor layer and now select your floor layer in your composition. And now let's play it back. Let's make it fit so you can see it. You can see that it's bouncing. Let's make it 50% so you can see it more. So wherever your floor is, that's where the bounce will occur. Let's make this like 20% opacity so we can kind of see the particles. Now, there's a cool property that I want to point out. Right now, the floor mode is set to infinite plane, which means it doesn't matter the size of your floor. It'll act like an infinite plane. But if you want the size of your layer to be exactly the size where you want the bounce to occur, you can switch it to layer size. But for this example, we'll stay with infinite plane. And we have a couple more properties that we can play with. Let's hide the floor, go back to physics. You can increase how much bounce you want. For example, if we make it 80, we'll get a lot of bounce. Let's back, you can see that it's really bouncy. Let's decrease this, let's make it 40. You can also increase a bounce random, maybe 35. And you can also adjust how much you want it to slide.
it's sliding a lot. So once a particle bounces, you can see that it kind of slides. You can make this maybe just a little bit of a slide, 10. So it'll bounce, it'll slide a little bit. And definitely for the collision event, definitely you want bounce. You have a couple of options. You can just make it slide, you can make it stick, for example, snow or rain. And you also have this called kill, which means is once it hits the floor, the particles disappear. So we'll stay with bounce. And the last parameter is we want to increase the speed of this. So we'll go to the physics time factor. Let's give it a value of 3. And this will definitely increase. This will increase the speed of your shatter. Let's play it back in real time. Now again, remember we were talking about velocity, and if we decrease the velocity to 150, you can see that it definitely affected the shatter and the location of your particles where it lands. So this is a value that you can definitely experiment with. Let's leave it at 300. Now let's change the sprite. There's one thing that I want to point out. Let's change the sprite to this cube sketch. Now when we play it back, you can see that the cubes are constantly moving. And one way to fix it is by going to the particles tab and going to texture, and for the time sampling, simply switch it to random still frame, and that should solve it. Now, let's go back to our sprite, and we'll switch it to low poly sphere. Just double click, and you can see that it's really dark. It's taking the pixel colors from our cutout, but it's really dark. Now, like I mentioned earlier, we can add a color curves, and let me show you how to do that. Let's go to color correction. Let's go to curves. We'll simply change this. And this should lighten up our particles. And let's go back again. Let's change it one more time. Let's go to sprite. And let's just change it to this one. Maybe make this a little less. So this is the basics of the shatter effect. Now let's bring in our footage. This is the footage that I exported out of Premiere. So you have your instructor CM and then followed by the clean plate. So let's bring it in. And let's see, right here at frame 20 is where we have the clean plate. So let's splice this layer. Control Shift D, Command Shift D to splice. And then this shot, I'm gonna put CM, and then this one will be our clean plate. It's good to rename your layer so you know exactly which layer is which. Let me just change the color. And then let's go to our particular layer. Let's bring it all the way up. And we want to slide it over. Let's change the color as well so I know that this is particular. And then right here, let's bring it over one. Right here, boom, it explodes. I added this shockwave. This is a stock footage from Action VFX, and this kind of helps sell the effect. So let's go ahead and let's add it. And it's a little slow, so let's right click, go to time stretch, and let's make it 20. This will speed it up, and then we'll bring it here, and let's move it up, let's scale it, S for scale, let's make it 150. And we can change the blending mode to add, or actually, let's go back and let's make it screen. This will help with the effect. And if you want to change the color, simply go to Effect, Color Correction, Hue and Saturation. We can go and select Colorize and play with the Colorize Hue. And that is it, amigos. That is using Particular to drive this shatter effect. Remember, that life is truly a gift, make it count.